We're having a difficult time with the phone calls. They tell me the audio portion of the audio board died. We'll have a funeral for the audio board in about 2 minutes. Stay tuned for the audio board funeral. Our guest is Swami Bhaktipad. I never heard of this, but so is something new after 33 years, a dead audio board. Swami Bhaktipad is Swami of the new Vrindavan. Can you explain what that means, the Vrindavan temple?
It means forest of tulsi trees. It's the place in India where Lord Krishna appeared 5,000 years ago.
What took you to this religion?
Well, in 1966, I was living in New York City, and a friend of mine met the Swami Prabhupada, the founder of this movement, on the street. And we had both been to India the year before, and we were interested to meet the man and talk to him. And Prabhupada convinced me very definitely by his life and by his words that he was a genuine spiritual master and could show me the way to love God.
And this was a logical conviction, not some sort of spiritual awakening one day you went to sleep a Baptist and woke up the next morning.
No, this happened over a period of a year.
Okay. What led you, though, to a higher calling, to want to be a Swami, to want to lead flock?
He instilled that desire in me by his example, by convincing me that life's real purpose is to serve God, and there is no higher service to a father than to reestablish the relationship of his lost son.
Now, when you say you got a calling to West Virginia, could you explain to the layman how a calling occurs?
Yes, I picked up a copy of the San Francisco Oracle, one copy in my whole life, and in that one copy there was one ad that the man put in there one time. And it was for a piece of land in West Virginia, which he said he wanted to give to make a religious community. And I saw that and I said, look, I want to go and see this. And when I saw the land, I loved it. And I thought, this would be a great place.
And who was the man?
His name is Richard Rhodes.
And is he a follower of the community?
No, he's not.
Did he give you the land?
No, he sold it to us.
So you raise money to buy this.
That's correct.
And then do your followers, are they supposed to come and live on the land? I mean, is that one of the purposes?
They don't have to come and live. They're welcome to.
Right.
But they don't have to. You can be a follower anywhere simply by dedicating your life to God and working for God's service.
And how are you supported?
The same way any church is supported, by the free will offerings of our members.
But all the people who live there, 400 live there, right?
That's correct.
How do they, like, their food, their livelihood, do they work? Do they go and work
in
the community?
Some do. Many of them make things there that are sold, and we support ourselves. We have one of the largest dairies in West Virginia. Hmm. We have about 300 or 400 cows.
Now, when someone started to complain about you, this began in the, what, early 80s or before that?
Well,
and it was Brian, an early complainer. How did this start?
For instance, back in the early 70s, some of our neighbors complained, and they tried to sue us and get us out of there.
Saying you were what, an annoyance?
Yeah, they said we were an annoyance, that we trespassed on their land, or some such things. And that also went to court and was found not to be true.
So in other words, thus far, nothing's been proven ever against
ever.
You. Charges are continuously made against
That's correct.
You, including as one as strong
this
as murder.
This is the third time. Three strikes, they're out.
Okay. Somebody, Swami, doesn't
Somebody
like
likes
you.
Us.
Somebody
up there likes us. That's what I'm concerned about. I'm not concerned about whether they like us down here. That'll pass. This whole world passes. It's a temporary world. In fact, this kind of reminds me, the first little booklet that our spiritual master Prabhupada wrote in this country was a little booklet called Who is Crazy? They say we're crazy, we think they're crazy. Now, who's right? What is the definition of sanity? The word sane comes from the French word sanus, which means healthy. Now, one is healthy when he perceives things as they are. When he lives in a fantasy world, or his hallucinatory world, he's insane. So the materialist is living his life on the premise that I'm this body. Now we say, you're not this body. And we can prove it.
Is that what the Hare Krishna say too?
Sure.
Right. You're still a Hare Krishna in soul, aren't you?
In philosophy, yes.
Even though the organized element
Definitely.
Is the church. Why are they so mad at you? Just because you don't believe there's only one master after?
Well, as I see it, they were threatened by certain people, and they became intimidated, and they said, all right, we'll get rid of him. And in exchange, they were going to get the property. This whole thing is a scam for property.
This is a very valuable piece.
You'll notice that in the indictment, about 40 pages have to do with all the charges, and about 70 pages have to do with what property is going to be seized. It's about property.
This is valuable property?
Yes. One of the things that makes it valuable is there's coal underneath it. And the coal company can't mine there as long as we're there. As long as we're building a big temple there, they can't mine there.
But if you lose, the other Hare Krishna sect gets it. So the Justice Department doesn't get it. The state of West Virginia doesn't get it. Another
sect
gets it.
No, but some politicians make their advantage. Therefore, there are several motives. But principally, it's a political motive. Political hay. And when this man lost the first round a couple of years ago, he became vindictive.
Mm-hmm.
I've got to get the Swami.
And that's what this is?
That's what it is.
A vendetta. And you can say now that
you said it.
Right,
It'll be decided in the court, and I have every faith that it'll be decided honorably, correctly, and I have faith in it.
And you can say here, since you're going to plead not guilty tomorrow, you had nothing to do with attempting to murder anyone.
No one. I have everything to do with trying to give everyone life, life eternal.
Did you love the gentleman in question, Mr. Bryan?
I love everyone.
Him too?
Because he's part and parcel of God.
We're all that.
We all are.
We're going to pause. We understand our phones may be okay now. We're going to pause, come back, and take some more calls for Swami Bhaktapada, and then more. This is Larry King Live in Washington. We're with you every night, Monday through Friday at 9 Eastern. By the way, at 1 a.m. Pacific time, repeated every night, we call it Larry King Overnight Novel, hey? We'll be back with some calls, hopefully.